Hello, this is Canon from NFT Art Generator. Today I'm excited to explain and demo the advanced mode of our NFT generation tool. If you haven't tried out the normal mode or this is your first time hearing about our tool, I recommend heading to nft-generator.art and checking it out after the video. I first want to briefly explain why we made the advanced mode and the new possibilities it unlocks. Previously, projects were limited to only one type of character, all sharing similar traits and attributes. It was hard to create multiple types of characters, or have characters with different gender-based traits. Our new advanced tool solves this issue. Using it, you can create as many different types of characters as you like, each with unique paths and attributes. No other script or tool out there is as powerful and customizable as what we have made. With the goal of making NFT generation easy and accessible for artists, removing the need for coding complex scripts, while still having the power to generate complex collections, was a necessity that we have brought to life. I am now going to demo the advanced tool with this project here. In this project, we have boy characters and girl characters, each with some shared traits and some unique traits. To see what types of characters this creates, I'll click the preview button a few times. Now let's build this project from scratch. You entered the advanced mode through the normal mode. We can get to the normal mode by clicking Get Started on our homepage. Now that we're in the normal mode, we can enter the advanced mode with this toggle up here in the top left. You'll notice the advanced mode also has the project panel and the layer panels. So let's name our project Boy and Girl and describe it as Boy and Girl NFTs. Our collection set to 5 and our dimensions not set yet because we haven't added any images. You'll notice as well with the layer panel here, this is whatever we have selected here. So how do we move the canvas? First of all, you can open the canvas by dragging down here. And to move about the canvas, you can press down and hold on your mouse, dragging around the canvas, and zooming in and out using the scroll wheel or the buttons here. So the white boxes on our screen are called layer nodes. There's the start layer node and the end layer node. Everything you want to happen to your NFT needs to occur in between. You'll see these connections are moving in the direction in which the events are occurring, with this layer occurring before it reaches the end. We can break a connection by clicking X right next to the percentage. And we can create a connection by dragging and connecting to the connector dots. Here's where things get interesting. You can add a new layer node by pressing on the connector dot. You do not only need to have one connection, you can have as many as you like. Just click again, and another one is made. Each one of these layers can have their own connections. And then multiple connections can occur to a single one, which can all be connected to the end. We're going to use this to help make our own Boy and Girl NFT project. Beyond connections and layer nodes, we also have tags up here in the top left. If I click the plus button, it'll create a new tag and prompt me to add a name. Let's call this tag Boy. We can make a second tag by pressing the plus button again. Let's call this tag Girl. You want to make your tags before you start your project. So now when I remove this connection, the tags will have appeared. I can recolor the tags by clicking on the color icon and choosing a color I like. So after the background, I want my characters to have a body, but I want the male body and the female body to each be unique. So I'm going to make a male path and a female path. I'm going to call each one of these body. So first it's going to create the background and add whatever images I put in here. Then it's going to have a 50-50 chance of going to each body. I can adjust those chances by playing with the rarity. And that can be happening to either one of these layer nodes. For now, let's leave it 50-50. I next want to make something after the body. This is going to be the head. They're both going to have the same type of head, so I'm going to make it so they connect together to this layer, which we're going to call the head. Now, 100% of all the NFTs and images being generated are going to come through this head layer node, coming from each body. But inside of this layer, it's still going to remember which ones are boys and which ones are girls, because the images are now tagged. So now we can continue onward and add eyebrows. And then we can add eyes, all of these traits that the characters share. Then we'll add a nose. Then we can add a mouth. And at any point, I can choose to break off and start another section, or start to choose the tag section. And these layers can be deleted by clicking on them, clicking the X button here. So now that I've gotten through my eyebrows, eyes, nose, and mouth, I want to have them have unique traits again. So the boy is going to have boy hair, and the girl is going to have longer hair. After the hair is applied, I want them to come back together again. And I want to give them a chance to have glasses. So I can adjust the chance of glasses by just lowering the rarity. Once I'm satisfied with the creation I've made, I can take the end and attach it to the glasses. It'll move around a little, but it'll still work. So to recap, it's going from the start, choosing a background that they're all gonna share, whatever images I put in there. Then I'll choose from this section of bodies and this section of bodies, tagging them with boy or girl. Then together, each one will go through these layer nodes with 100% chance, get to the mouth, and then it's gonna decide, checking whether or not it's a female or a male, and routing it down the correct path. So even though it says 50-50, only female ones will go down this path, and only male ones will go down this path. It'll have a chance of getting glasses, and then it will reach its end and be generated. I cut ahead to when I've added my images, just by dragging and dropping into the section here, or clicking on this button here. And now the background has all of these backgrounds that'll be run. Here are the male bodies and the female bodies. They'll each share a head, eyebrows, eyes, nose, mouth. And then when it gets to hair, it'll either choose to give the male hair or the female hair, depending on the tag. Then I'll go through the glasses, get to the end, and be generated. So let's try this out. There we go, it's generating both male and female characters with their respective traits and attributes. There truly is no limit now to generating your own NFTs. You can make them as complex and customized as you like. As you see here, even without tags, the advanced mode can make some really crazy stuff. Personally, I like to use bundle layers that are empty with no image to lower the amount of connections that I need to make. We cannot wait to see what amazing NFTs you guys create using the new tool. Join our new Discord linked in the description to share your work, give product feedback, and participate in the NFT Art Generator community. We have some more amazing features and updates coming very soon, so make sure to stay notified by following our Twitter and subscribing to the channel. Goodbye, and happy creating.